What's up, Teal Fam? Hi, fam. How's it going? I feel like it's been a long time since I've done a pulse check with everybody, checked in with my family, and see how y'all are doing. So I wanted to do that right now, today, at this moment. So, I'm home alone right now. My partner is out of state for work, and the child's son, we asked him if he would rather stay with me or go with the grandparents, and obviously he chose the grandparents because, first and foremost, they don't make him eat his vegetables like I do, and he absolutely despises most vegetables. You know what, for the parents out there who follow me, let me know what your tips and tricks are to getting a child to eat their vegetables, because, like, I don't know, y'all, it's just not working. And, you know, I'm a bit of a disciplinarian, more so than my partner, so I'm like, he needs to eat at least this much of his vegetables, and, like, honestly, he would rather starve than eat his vegetables. So it's a work in progress. And also, you know, here he has a very structured day, if you will. Like, his bedtime is normally between 7:30 and 8, so he can get his good, you know, 10 to 12 hours of sleep a night and be fresh and ready for school. And you know, grandparents are grandparents, so they're a little more lenient. So it's just me for the next week. So sorry I haven't checked in. I've been so busy. And there goes the loud cars. Honestly, y'all, is there a state more rowdy than Florida? Like, I know New York City is like a city that never sleeps, and Vegas is, you know, whatever happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, but I swear Florida has the loudest cars of all time. Anyways, I thought I would sit down and catch up with everybody. If you would like, get a bite to eat and sit down and eat with me. Pour a glass of wine, get a drink, make some juice, some sleepy time tea, you know, whatever, but let's just chill and hang out for a bit. And I want to know how everyone's doing and kind of explain what's been going on in my world. was everyone's Halloween? We didn't really do anything over here. We took Sun trick-or-treating in the grandparents' neighborhood because we live in an apartment, so we don't really have the option to go trick-or-treating. But the grandparents have a nice little circular neighborhood, so it's very like, I don't know, it has a nice community feeling, and there were lots of families sitting outside, passing out candy, and it was really nice. Every time I order shrimp and steak from no matter what restaurant it is, they always put the shrimp on a piece of bread. Can someone tell me what the reason for that is? Is it to like soak in the moisture so it's not so wet? Or I don't know. I never eat the bread. I just always think it's interesting. Let's dig into some mac and cheese. Sitting at home on like Snapchat and Instagram watching everyone having a great time, and I was so happy for them. But also like the stress of getting up and going out, like now it's stressful to me. When I was younger it was like a good time, but now it's just kind of like getting up, getting dressed, having to get an Uber, which is going to be super expensive because everyone's Ubering and lifting. It just, you know, that's kind of lost its appeal for me as I get older, which is natural. But yeah, I hope everyone had a good and safe Halloween. And I feel like just about across the whole United States, it's gotten significantly cooler in temperature. So how's everyone liking the cooler temperature? Because I know at least in Florida, you know, I feel like we were kicking it around the 80 degree mark, 80, 85. And we've gotten kind of like a cold front, and it's been down in like the 60s, even sometimes a low of 50s, and I have been absolutely freezing. It's been like a cold front that came across the United States, so I think it's been cooler pretty much about everywhere. But like, that's just not what I'm here for. I don't enjoy the cold weather. I didn't move to Florida for cold weather. I need to be in shorts and a t-shirt. Staring at me as if he wasn't just over there munching, crunching, and brunching on his dog food. I'm like, sir, can I have some peace, please? Oh no, y'all, he's on the way. Panic. respect me because I ain't got the normal bass in my voice. Go. Go lay down. He ain't gonna do it. You gotta get that. Go lay down, boys. But yeah. Also, has anyone had to deal with all of these flight cancellations that are happening? It's been so bad and affecting so many people. Sorry, I know I mean a little unclassy, but it is what it is, and it ain't what it ain't. So anyone who watched my 1,000K subscribers video, not the Q&A, but the one before that, you would know that. So my partner was directly affected by these like mass flight cancellations, and I had driven up from Florida to Baltimore. I still did not have my car back. My car is still in Rocky Mount, North Carolina. So basically, what ended up happening is we took it to like this mom and pop shop because it was the only one open on a Sunday. Like I have a Hyundai, and the Hyundai dealership was not open on Sunday. And so basically, when I told them what happened, they kind of had this look on their face like, "Ooh." This is going. And the mechanic was like, this is the third Hyundai this week that we've seen with the same issue. So basically, it seems that Hyundai's between like a 10-year manufacturing period, a lot of them have these like engine failure issues, right? So it's called a P2613 reading on your engine. And basically, it's like your rod bearings go bad. And I'm just reciting to you what they told me. I don't know anything about the mechanics of a car. But basically, like, your rod bearings go bad. And your vehicle is not able to accelerate past 60 miles an hour. But it comes out of absolutely nowhere. Like, I keep great regular maintenance on my car. Less than 100,000 miles, like, shouldn't be happening, right? But once the mechanic saw the issues, he was like, "Oh yeah, this is a very common Hyundai issue. Since your car has less than 100,000 miles, I would try and get in contact with the Hyundai manufacturer to see if it's under warranty." So I was like, "Well, am I able to get the car back to Florida?" And he was like, "No, you do that, you're gonna ruin the whole engine. There's not gonna be a car after that." So I was like, "Okay." Ended up renting a car and driving back to Florida. Right? So insurance to tow the car. The people were so sweet. If I could think of the name of the shop, I would shout them out, but I don't recall at the moment. But I was able to get my car towed with my insurance from the mom and pop shop to the Hyundai dealership in Rocky Mount, North Carolina. And the lady was basically like, because I called to check on it, and she was like, "I don't know why your car is here." And so I told her, and she was like, "Oh, okay, I understand, but like, we're 2 to 3 months out on fixing engines, you know, of that problem." Sunday corporate, and they won't, they basically won't tell you if they're going to cover it or not until you take it to a Hyundai and find out what the issue is. But I took the key with me, so they couldn't even check the vehicle. So we've been, you know, going through different auto transport companies trying to find a good price to have the vehicle towed from North Carolina to Florida. Finally found one. It was going to cost me $850 to have it transported, right? Like, this is a awful experience. So it's supposed to get picked up tomorrow and be delivered on Thursday. Today's Tuesday, by the way. Tuesday evening. So it's just like, it's a lot. It's a lot. And then from everything I've read online, you basically have to fight with Hyundai to get them to cover this engine issue. So many years of your oil change records and whatnot. It's like, but honestly, anyone go to Google and type in B2613 and literally you will see that hundreds of Hyundai horror stories that have the exact same story as what I experienced. So it's still an ongoing issue. Luckily, I work from home, so it's not like it's a huge deal. His car while he's out of town until Friday. Besides that, let me tell y'all, life has been busy. And by the way, Quay ASMR, if you're watching this, I saw you posting about you didn't make it to your college class the other day. Wait, you better cut that out. Go and get your education, boo. But school has been so super busy. You know, we're getting to that. Snake is a little bit batty. We're getting to that point of the year where you're preparing all your final projects, preparing for your final exams in a month. So it's just been crazy. Let me tell you, work was busy and it's only gotten busier. And I'm actually currently at work trying to apply for a lower paying position because this job has continued to put more and more work on us to like an unreasonable level. But obviously, no pay has increased. And I told my supervisor, like, I can't do it anymore. It's too much. It's too much. I'm like, I just feel like y'all don't care for your employees. Which, I mean, we all know, you know, corporate America. All about making a dollar, but, you know, you have to have respect for yourself and care for yourself first, and in which I can simply just cut out some of the ancillary spending I do. To take a few $1,000 pay cut to be able to, enjoy my day and not be literally mentally exhausted by the end of the day. I'm willing to do that. So, I know it's like a definitely here in the United States, a lot of companies are really suffering with them, you know, being understaffed and whatnot, but just the world we're living in, I guess. By the way, don't. as much fat of the steak off as possible. Like, we're trying to get better about eating red meat and pork, because obviously they're not great for you. But steak is just so good. Anyways, what's everyone's plans for Thanksgiving? Originally.